We'll continue with another Scottish one, and this is about a journey from Glasgow, or back to Glasgow, to the west coast, and a little place called Carradale, which is a tiny wee place. If it was any bigger, it would be a hamlet, and it's on the Mull of Kintyre. You've probably heard of the Mull of Kintyre. Some guy, Paul somebody, sang a song about it. And by the way, Carradale is very close to Campbelltown, which is another place you've got here. In this song, the person starts a journey from Glasgow in the morning, and they make their way west. And as they travel, they're passing through some spectacular countryside, some of which is mentioned in the song. For example, there's a mountain. You would maybe call it a hill, I don't know, called the Cobbler, which is supposed to represent, when you look at it, a cobbler striking his hammer on a shoe. I've never worked it out myself. It's just a mountain as far as I can see. Anyway, and just after that, you go up a big glen, which has a wonderful name. It's called Rest and Be Thankful. Inspired name. You pass through various little towns and lochs. Is there an Inverary in Australia? An Inverary?
I doubt it.
Inverell.
Well, close enough. you pass through Inverary. Anyway, as I say, the person is travelling through some spectacular countryside, and by the time they reach their destination at the end of the day, their spirits have been uplifted. So it's a mental as well as a physical journey. And it's called Carradale, and you can relax because there's no chorus. Okay.
I took the road reluctantly, a little bit forlorn, with no one there beside to ask me why. But when I got to Paragar and came upon Loch Long, the cobbler high above me made me smile. The air was growing sweeter, and the water lay serene that sunny day. Hey, I took the road to Carradale. I was grateful by the time the rest and thankful had been won. Inverary lay ahead, and I didn't feel so bad. It already seemed, although my journey wasn't such a long time since I'd risen from my bed. The road was slow and twisting as I rounded every turn, and another view to look upon and take my breath away. I knew there was no need for haste, and so I took my time that sunny day. I took the road to Carradale. I headed for Loch Gilpin and turned southward once again, meandering by Crinan and Ardrishig on Loch Fyne, then somewhere after Tarbertin.